Hello students, welcome to Oxygen Education, and today we will start exercise 2.3 of chapter number 2, linear equation in one variable. Now, so here the question is, solve the following equations and check your result. So here you have to give one equation, you have to solve that equation, also you have to verify your results. First question, we are given 3x equal to 2x plus 18. This is one linear equation in one variable. You have to solve this equation. First, you have to solve this equation and then you have to check your result. That means you have to do verification. Now, students, so given equation is 3x equal to 2x plus 18. So here total 3 terms are there. In these 2 terms are like terms. So we are taking like terms on the same side of the equal to. So we are taking this 2x on the left hand side. So it will become negative. So first term is 3x minus 2x equal to 18. Done? Now 3 minus 2. These are the like terms. So 3x minus 2x, that is equal to x. So answer is x equal to. Here, x equal to 18 is called the solution of given equation. What is x? X equal to 18 is called solution of this given equation. Now, you have to verify this result. So, next step is your verification. Now, what is verification? So, you have to verify whether this x equal to 18 is the solution of given equation or not. So in our equation, this is equal to sign, and this is called the left hand side of this equation, and this is called right hand side of this equation. So first we are taking left hand side of the equation. So it is known as LHS, left hand side. So left hand side of this equation is 3x. So we have to write 3 into x. Value of x is 18. So 3 18s are 54. The value of the equation on the left hand side is 54. Now this is the right hand side. So now we are finding the value of the right hand side, 4, x equal to 18. So right hand side is 2 into 18 plus 18. So it is 2 into 18, it's a 36 plus 18, which is equal to 54. So students, here we can say that for x equal to 18, the left hand side of the equation is become right hand side. Value of the left hand side of the equation is become right hand side. Both values are equal. Therefore, x equal to 18 is our solution. Done? So here verification is left hand side. Now, question number 2. We are given 5t minus 3 equal to 3t minus 5. 3t minus 5. Done? So, this is our given linear equation. Here, our variable is t. So what we are doing, taking the like terms on the same side of the equal to. So these are the terms with variable. So they are taking this term on the left hand side. These are the constant terms. So keep this constant term on the another side. So we are taking this 3t on the left hand side. That is known as transposition. What we are doing? We are doing transposition of the terms. Transposition of like terms. So the positive term will become negative term. And this minus 3, which is negative term, that will become positive term. So here, on the left hand side, 5t is there. Now taking this plus 3t on the left hand side, so after transposition of this 3t term, it will become minus 3t. Clear students? Now, on the right hand side, this minus 5 is already there. We are taking the transposition of this minus 3. So this minus 3 will go into the right hand side. So this minus 3 will become plus 3. So this is plus 3. Clear students? Now here, this is our like terms. Done? So subtraction of this 5t minus 3t is 2t equal to. Now this one is minus 5 plus 3. What is minus 5 plus 3? It's a minus 2. So therefore, we can write this 2 in the division of this minus 2. So therefore, t equal to, this is minus 2 by 2. And therefore, we are getting t equal to, what is the value of t? 2 ones are 1. So this is equal to minus 1. Clear? So here, solution is t equal to minus 1. Now I have to verify it. So verification. So for that, we have to consider the left hand side of the equation. So what is the left hand side of the equation? 5t minus 3. So which is 5t minus 3. What is the solution of the equation? T equal to minus 1. So put t equal to minus 1, minus 1 over here. It's a 5 into minus 1 minus 3. Now 5 into minus 1 minus 5. And this is minus 3. So both terms are negative. So you have to perform addition. You have to put the sign of largest number, which is equal to minus 8. So the left hand side, the value of the left hand side of the equation is minus 8. Yeah? So left hand side of this equation is minus 8. Now you have to consider right hand side. So what is right hand side? Which is RHS. The right hand side of this equation is 3t minus 5. 3t minus 5. Put t equal to minus 1. It's a 3 into minus 1 minus 5. So this is equal to minus 3 minus 5. So RHS. What is RHS? Minus 8. So here you can clearly see that minus 8 equal to minus 8. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So verification is there. Now, question number 3. In third sum, we are given 5x plus 9. 5x plus 9, that is equal to 5 plus 3x. 5 plus 3x. This is very similar to question number 2. Here our variable is x. In previous sum, our variable is. Done? So first you have to solve this equation. Solving this equation means you have to find the value of variable x. So this is the variable x. So what is the first step? Taking both the like terms on the same side of the equation and another type of term on the right hand side of the equation. So term with the variable, we are keeping that term on the left hand side. So this one is 5x. This plus 3x will become minus 3x. And that is equal to 5 already on the right hand side. Now transposing this plus 9 on the right hand side, so it will become minus 9. Clear? 5x as it is, 3x on the left hand side, so it's a minus 3x equal to 5 already is there, taking plus 9 on the right hand side, so it's a minus. Now this one, 5x minus 3x, like terms are there, so you have to consider the subtraction of coefficients. 5 minus 3, 5 minus 3 is 2x. So this one is 2x and this is equal to 5 minus 9 plus minus, you have to consider minus and the largest number is 9, so it's a minus 9, so that is minus 4. Now again we are transposing this 2, which is in multiplication, so it will go into division. Therefore x equal to minus 4 by 2 and therefore this x equal to 13, 2 to the x equal to minus 2 is the solution of this given equation. In each sum, we are given two parts. First, you have to solve this equation. After solving equation, you have to check your result. So you have to check whether your answer is correct or not, whether the solution given by this solution is correct or not. So for that, we are doing verification. So again, verification. So for verification, you have to consider right hand side of the equation. The given right hand side of the equation is 5x plus 9. from 9, so it will be minus 1. And the value of the right hand side of the equation, right hand side, that is equal to 5 plus 3x. So that is equal to 5 plus x, x is minus 2. So this is equal to 5 minus 6. 3 into minus 2, which is minus 6. So what is 5 minus 6? 5 minus 6 is minus 1. So here, value of the left hand side is minus 1 and the value of right hand side is minus 1. Done? So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So our solution is right. Now, next one, that is question number 4. So in fourth question, we are given 4z plus 3. 4z plus 3 equal to 6 plus 2z. 6 plus 2z. So here your variable is z. So taking this term with the z variable on the left hand side, constant terms on the right hand side. So therefore, this one is 4z minus 2z equal to 6 minus 3. 4z minus 2z, which is equal to 2z, equal to 3. And therefore, our z is, 2 is in multiplication, it will go into division. So that is 3 by 2. Z equal to 3 by 2 is the solution of given equation. Now verification. So verification. For that we will consider left hand side. Left hand side of the equation is 4z plus 3. This is on left hand side. Put the value of z over there. So z is 3 by 2 plus 3. Now simplification. It's a 4 into 3 by 2. So you have to cut this 2. 2 plus a 4. 3 plus a 6 plus 3. So value of our left hand side of the equation is 9. Left hand side is 9. Clear? Now what is right hand side? Right hand side is 6 plus 2z. So that is equal to 6 plus 2 into z, 3 by 2. Again, 2 into 3 by 2. So this 2 will be given. So it's a 3 plus 6. So right hand side equal to 9. What is the value of left hand side? Left hand side is 9. Right hand side is 9. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we can verify our result. Clear? So now next, pause the video to note it all. Okay students, now question number 5. In question number 5, we are given 2x minus 1. 2x minus 1 equal to 14 minus x. This is one given equation. We have to solve this given equation and then you have to check it. So therefore, if I have the light term, taking this minus signs on the left hand side. So it will become positive. So it's a 2x plus x. 14 as it is. And taking this minus 1 on the right hand side. So it's a plus 1. So 2x plus x, light term, the addition of light term is addition of its coefficient, which is 3x equal to 14 plus 1, that is 15. Now, transposition of this 3. 3 is in multiplication of the x. So if you transpose this 3 on the right hand side, it will go into division. So therefore, x equal to 15 by 3. Clear students? Now, this is 15 by 3. So this is equal to 3 5s are 15. Therefore, solution is x equal to 5. So x equal to 5. X equal to 5 is called solution of given linear equation. Done? Now we have to verify it. So verification. Verification. So what you have to do for verification? Yes, you have to put value of x in left hand side. So So left hand side is 2x minus 1. Now you have to put this x equal to 5 in the place of x. You said 2 into 5 minus 1. What is 2 5 is 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1 is nothing but the number 9. Very good. Left hand side is equal to 9. Now students, we are finding the value of RHS right hand side, which is equal to 14 minus x. Yes. What is x? Equal to 5. So 14 minus 5 equal to 9. So yahan par hamara aa gaya right hand side. What is the value of right hand side? 9. Clear? Now comparing on left hand side and right hand side. Left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we can verify our result. So it is true. Our solution is true. Now next one is question number 6. For 6 we are given 8x plus 4. 8x plus 4 equal to 3 into x minus 1. 3 into x minus 1 plus 7. This is given. Well, 8x plus 4 equal to 3 into x minus 1 plus 7. Now, we will throw down difficulty to increase 1. Now, we have to solve this equation. Yes, it is right. So here, this is one term with variable, this is the constant term, but here 3 into this bracket is here. So first you have to open the bracket. Kya karenge hum? Ye jo bracket diya hua hai, usko hum open karenge. So uske liye karna padega expansion. So therefore, this one is 8x plus 4 equal to, ekdam easy hai, math pura easy hai, dekho. 3 into x, 3x minus 3 into 1, 3 plus 7. Again. Now, this one is minus 3 plus 7. Oh, minus 3 plus 7 kya hota hai? So, therefore, 8x plus 4 equal to 3x minus 3 plus 7 plus 4. We are the given. So, these are the like terms. You have to keep this like term on the same side. So, this one is 8x minus 3x and this is equal to 4 minus 4. 4 minus 4 kya hota hai? 5x equal to 0. So x equal to 0. What is the solution of this equation? X equal to 0. If you are taking x equal to 0 on the left hand side and x equal to 0 on the right hand side, it will solve our equation. So let's check it. Verification. Left hand side. Left hand side of the equation is 8x plus 4. 8x plus 4. What you have to do? Put x equal to 0 over here. So it's 8 into 0 plus 4. 8 into 0 kitna hota hai? 0. Very good. So it's a 4. So left hand side of the equation is 4. Similarly, what is the value of right hand side? Right hand side is 3 into x minus 1 plus 7. Put x equal to 0. So it's a 3, 0 minus 1 plus 7. 0 minus 1 kitna hota hai? Minus 1. So it's a 3 into minus 1 plus 7. 3 into minus 1 minus 3 plus 7. Minus 3 plus 7, which is equal to 4. So our value of right hand side of the equation is 4. Yes, left hand side of equation is equal to right hand side. So here we can verify our result. Clear? Now question number 7. We are given x equal to 4 by y into x plus 10. Clear? Solve this equation and we have to verify. Kaise karenge bolo? So here, first we will try to simplify this fraction. Fraction देखे दे तो ऐसा लगता है कि थोड़ा difficult है. लेकिन बिल्कुल इसे this 5 is in division with this entire bracket. So first we have to transpose this 5. It is in division. So if we 5, if we take this 5 on the left hand side, it will come into the multiplication. So this 5 will come into multiplication with this x. So it's a 5x. 5x equal to this 4 as it is into x plus 10. Now simplify over here. ब्रैकेट के साथ कोई नंबर आ गया तो क्या करते हैं, एक्सपांशन। एक्सपांशन का मतलब क्या हो रहा है, यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस नंबर विद द वेरिएबल, उसको बोलते हैं एक्सपांशन। इट्स अ 4x है ना, 4 को x के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करो और 4 को 10 के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करो, बीच में प्लस कर दो, सो इट्स अ 4x 4 into x plus 4 into 10 40। अब यहां समझ लो बच्चों, यस वेरी गुड। नाउ टेक दिस 4x ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, so this one is 5x minus 4x equal to 40, yes, so 5x minus 4x, so it is x, so x equal to 40, this is our solution. Now we have to verify our result, ye pura verify karte hain hona this is space mein, so left hand side very simple, what is left hand side, this x, x equal to 40. So left hand side is 40, it is only x. Now right hand side, right hand side equal to 4 by 5 into x plus 10, what is x, 40 plus 10, and right hand side 4 by 5 into x plus 10, putting x equal to 40, so 40 plus 10 kya hota hai, 4 by 5, 40 plus 10, 50, very good, so 5 tens are 50, so 4 tens are 40, so RHS is 40, clear, so here left hand side is equal to our right hand side, done. Now next one is question number 8, 4 8, we are given 2x by 3, 2x plus 1 by 3, 2x plus 1 by 3, sorry, it's a 2x by 3 plus 1, 2x by 3 plus 1 equal to 7x by 15 plus 3, 7x by 15 plus 3, yes, this is correct, right? So first we are simplifying on the left hand side, then we will simplify on the right hand side, and then we will cross multiply. So here, taking 3 as LCM, multiply this 3 with this 1. So we are having 2x plus 3 multiplied by 3 को 1 के साथ multiply किया. Similarly, 15 को 3 के साथ multiply करेंगे. So x plus 7x plus 45 by 15. Clear? Cross multiply, we can say taking LCM. Now again, multiply this 3 with this center bracket, 15 with this center bracket, cross multiplication, done. So that will be 15 into 2x plus 3, that is equal to, and here 15 division mein hai, transposition karenge to multiplication mein aega, yahan par 3 division mein hai, iska transposition karenge to upper multiplication mein aega, so it's a 3 into 7x plus 45, so this one 15 into 30x plus 15 3 is 45, here 7 3 is 21x plus 45 3 is 35 is 15, 34 is 12 and 13 135, clear students, cross multiply kiya na, division mein tha to multiplication mein chala gaya, yahan par division mein tha to multiplication mein gaya, uske baad yahan par kya kiya, expansion hai na, last two sums mein jo kiya wahi expansion kiya yahan par, now ये सम्स तो बहुत सारे किए, लेकिन 21x ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, सो दिस वन इज 30x माइनस 21x इक्वल टू 135 माइनस 45, क्लियर, ट्रांसपोजिशन ऑफ लाइक टर्म्स, सो दिस वन 30x माइनस 21x व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 9x, व्हाट इज 135 माइनस 45 व्हिच इज 90, सो स्टूडेंट्स x इक्वल टू टेकिंग दिस 9 इनटू डिवीजन, so 90 by 9 which is equal to 10, so answer x equal to 10, x equal to 10. Now verify it, so for verification we have to consider left hand side first, so left hand side is 2x plus 2x by 3 plus 1 So putting x equal to 10, so 2 into 10 by 3 plus 1, so 2 into 10 in our 20 plus 1 into 3 by 3, so this one is 23 by 3. Value of left hand side is 23 by 3. Similarly, value of right hand side RHS, that is equal to 7 into x, x is 10 divided by 15 plus 3. Here we can perform the simplification. 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 10 by 15. So 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15. 7 2s are 14 by 3 plus 3. So this is equal to 3 3s are 9, 14 by 9 by 3. So that is equal to 23 by 3. So value of the right hand side is 23 by 3. Value of the left hand side is 23 by 3. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So it's verified. Clear? So pause the video to monitor. Okay students, now question number 9. So this is 2y, this is minus y. So taking like term on the same side. So here we are getting 2y plus y equal to, this one is 26 by 3, taking this plus 5 by 3 on the right hand side, so it is minus 5 by 3. Clear? Minus y will become plus y, this plus 5 by 3 will become minus 5 by 3. Therefore, now 2y plus y, that is equal to 3y. Here, simplification. So 3 is the LCM. So you have to perform subtraction of numerator, which is 26 minus 5. So here 3y equal to 26 minus 5, 21 by 3. Cutting 3 is 21. Therefore, we are getting y as this is 7 and this is going to be division. So we are getting y equal to 7 by 3. Now verification. So over right hand side is 2y plus 5 by 3. So here putting y equal to 7 by 3. So 2 into 7 by 3 plus 5 by 3. So what is 2 into 7? 2 into 7 is 14. So 14 by 3 plus 5 by 3. Same. The 3 is the same. So it's a 14 plus 5. You have to perform addition of numerator when denominator are equal. So denominator is 3, so you have to consider addition of numerator. So it's a 14 plus 5. So 14 plus 5 is 19 by 3. Done? It is our left hand side. So now we consider our right hand side, which is equal to 26 by 3 minus y. Y is 7 by 3. Again, LCM is 3. You have to consider subtraction of numerator only. It is 26 minus 7. 26 minus 7 is how that? 19 by 3. So, value of right hand side is 19 by 3. Value of the here, so left hand side. Left hand side is 19 by 3. So, both are equal. Clear? Last sum. So this one is minus 8 by 5, taking minus 8 by 5 on the left hand side. So it will become positive, 8 by 5 equal to, now this 3m taking on the right hand side. So it will become 5m minus 3m. Simple. So that is equal to 8 by 5 equal to, now this 5m minus 3m, we are getting 2m. Our variable is m, this 2 is in multiplication. Come into the division. So it's a 8 upon 5 by 2 equal to n. So what is the value of n? 8 by 10. It's a 8 by 10. This is the value of our n. Verification 9. So this is 2y, this is minus y. So taking like term on the same side. So here we are getting 2y plus y equal to, this one is 26 by 3, taking this plus 5 by 3 on the right hand side, so it is minus 5 by 3. Clear? Minus y will become plus y, this plus 5 by 3 will become minus 5 by 3. Therefore, now 2y plus y, that is equal to 3y. Here, simplification. So 3 is the LCM. So you have to perform subtraction of numerator, which is 26 minus 5. So here, 3y equal to 26 minus 5, 21 by 3. Cut in, 3 is on the 21. Therefore, we are getting our y as, this is 7, and this is going to be division. So we are getting y equal to 7 by 3. Now, verification. So over, right hand side is 2y plus 5 by 3. So here, putting y equal to 7 by 3. So 2 into 7 by 3 plus 5 by 3. What is 2 into 7? 2 into 7 is 14. So 14 by 3 plus 5 by 3. Same. The 3 is the LCM. So it's a 14 plus 5. You have to perform addition of numerator when denominator are equal. So denominator is 3. So you have to consider addition of numerator. So it's a 14 plus 5. So 14 plus 5 is 90 by 3. Done? It is our left hand side. So now we consider our right hand side, which is equal to 26 by 3 minus y. Y is 7 by 3. Again, LCM is 3. You have to consider subtraction of numerator only. It's a 26 minus 7. 26 minus 7 is how that? 19 by 3. So when your right hand side is 19 by 3, when you have the here, so left hand side. Left hand side is 19 by 3. So both are equal. Clear? Last sum. So this one is minus 8 by 5, taking minus 8 by 5 on the left hand side. So it will become positive, 8 by 5 equal to, now this 3m taking on the right hand side. So it will become 5m minus 3m. Simple. So that is equal to 8 by 5 equal to, now this 5m minus 3m, we are getting 2m. Our variable is m, this 2 is in multiplication, it will come into the division. So 8 upon 5 by 2 equal to n. So what is the value of n? 8 by 10. It's a 8 by 10. This is the value for n. Verification. So for verification, we'll consider left hand side of the equation. So left hand side is 3 into n. So put n equal to 8 by 10. So here 3 into 8, which is 24 by 10. So value of left hand side is 24 by 10. So it's a 2.4. Now right hand side of this equation, which is 5n minus 8 by 5. So it's a 5 into n. N is 8 by 10. So it's a 8 by 10 minus 8 by 5. So it's a 5 2 is 10. Simplification. 2 4 is 8. So which is 4 minus 8 by 5. So what is our right hand side? 5 4 is 20. 20 minus 8 by 5. 20 minus 8. 12 by 5. Now this is 2.4, this is 12 by 5. Are they equal? Are they equal? So let's check it. 12 upon 5. What we are doing? We are multiplying numerator and denominator with 2. So what is 2 by 2? 2 by 2 is 1. So multiplying any number with 1 will be the same number. So this is equal to 12 plus 24 and 5 plus 10. So this is equal to 2.4. Clear? So this 2.4 and 12 by 5 are the same number. So this is the verification of question number 10.